Okay, I'm going to attempt to do something we've thrown together here, and I think we've got it right, but we'll see. We have special guests and candidates that we would like to acknowledge, and I'm going to list those and have them stand. I think it would work best, and we'll appreciate them at a later date, or other will be here all night long. So I'm going to start with, you all know Bill, Senator Bill from here, but we also have Senator Norm Sanderson. County Commissioners Hood Richardson and Stan Dethridge. Register of Deeds Jennifer Leggett Whitehurst. Oakland County School Board Chairman Cindy Winstead. Oakland County School Board Vice Chairman Terry Williams. Oakland County School Board Member Mike Isbell. Third District GOP Chair Bob Pruitt. Fifth County Republican Party Chairman Jenny Cooper. And her husband Ron Cooper, who is Winterville Town Councilman. We have Washington County Chairman Kim Cotton West. And her husband Al Pam, Vice Chairman Harvey West. We also have some candidates. We've got a United States Senate candidate, Dr. Greg Brannon here. We have two Beaufort County Sheriff candidates, Donald Dixon. And also, where is it?
Okay.
I can relate. And also Sheriff candidate Rick Guthrie. And we also have Beaufort County Republican Party Chairman candidate Keith Kidwell. I believe we've got Beaufort County Republican Party Vice Chairman candidate, Dick Denton. I think I've got everybody, but there's so many, I'm not sure. I'll take a moment to have three of our representatives have a word with us for 2 minutes apiece. We'll start with Senator Norm Sanderson.
But I'll try. I just want to share something with you that a lot of you may not know. I think that everything that we do in Raleigh first has to be bathed in prayer, because nobody knows how to do it better than our Heavenly Father knows how to do it. And we have just started, for the first time, as far as I know, in the history of our state government, a legislative prayer caucus, which we'll pray every day before we go into session about the laws that we have to vote on. And it's there, and in fact, next week on the Capitol grounds, we're going to have a prayer rally from folks from across the state praying about the slave trafficking in North Carolina. Whether you know it or not, we have a very big problem with all of our military bases and all of the other people that we have coming into our state, and the interstate highway, I-95, we have a huge problem with sex trafficking in this state. And then so far, we've kind of kept it under wraps because nobody wants to admit it's there. And we're beginning to pass legislation to address that, and I'm really proud to be a part of that, and we're going to come together with prayer warriors from all over the state next week, and we're going to pray that spirit off of our state because it needs to go away. And so there's a lot of great things going on in Raleigh, a lot of things that folks don't know. We just need your support. Please, if there's something that happens that you don't understand, don't get in the rumor mill. Pick up the phone and call and ask us what's going on. because we're glad to talk to you and explain what we're doing and why we're doing it, because you're the ones that are going to keep us in Raleigh or keep somebody conservative like us in Raleigh in 2 years. There's a lot of people watching us, a lot of people looking for us to make any mistake that we can so that they can use it against us. So keep us lifted up in prayer. If anybody comes to you and wants to say something bad about what's going on in Raleigh, you need to call us. If you don't know how to answer them, you call us and we'll give you an answer. Right, Bill? Thank you.
And 3rd District Representative Mike Spishali.
If I didn't get to you and say thank you, I want to say thank you. Thank you for your support. We're doing a lot of good stuff up there. I'll tell you, there's a lot of good people up there. There are a lot of new freshmen. The majority of the House has been there less than 2 years. So the old guard is gone, and you've got some new blood in place, and a lot of these guys are strong conservatives. We're getting things through. There's a lot of bills in the work. We're getting emails. How come you don't have a bill on this? And how come nobody submitted this? And how come? Trust me, if you can think of an idea, there's a bill in the works. There's a lot of Second Amendment bills. The resolution that Beaufort County, first in the nation, the county commissioners did, I took that, made a couple of tweaks to it, and submitted it. And it was my first bill that I got through committee. And I'll tell you, they beat me over the head with it. It's going to be coming out on the House floor here shortly. But it was a wonderful experience. Just boom, 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 firing back and forth. So it was a good learning experience. I just want you to know we're up there working hard for you, doing everything we can. We need your help. If you can go online to the General Assembly website, you can pull our names up, you can see the bills we've got, you can search for specific issues that you may be interested in and look at the bills. If you find bills that you think need to be supported, let us know. But don't just let me know or Senator Sanderson or him. You need to let every one of them up there know, and you can pull all their emails, put them together, and send it to every representative and every senator up there, because trust me, your comments, your emails, and your input does work to influence. Well, you'll see that if you look at some of the bills, you'll say, how did this thing get in? There was somebody out there that put some pressure on them to put in a bill. So it does work. We work for you. We know we work for you. At least the freshmen know we work for you. And we're going to continue to fight the fight on your behalf. Thank you.
And we also have U.S. Senate candidate Greg Brennan. Well, it's an honor to be here, and I thought amongst friends talking about the Constitution. Real quick about myself, I'm a Christian, pro-life, servant citizen with 7 children, 6 of them are girls. So, an active OB, I delivered 2 babies this morning. Heard the Senate governor mention the word federalism. That's why I'm running for U.S. Senate. The Constitution is what the government can do. The Bill of Rights is what they cannot do. The Bill of Rights come from God. They are nature's laws listed down where the federal government has no power in them at all.
Amen.
We need sovereign states and legislators to say no more to that. I'm going to go and I'm going to win, and I'm going to act as an ambassador from the sovereign state of North Carolina representing the constitutional law. We do that, paradigm shift changes. We have to understand what is the legitimate role of government. And our founders declared it in the Declaration of Independence. It's only legitimate if it protects our inalienable rights. Life from the natural conception of natural passing. Obamacare is an abomination. Number 2, without life, you don't have liberty. Liberty comes with responsibility. Without that, you cannot pursue your dream. Madison talked about the most important property is your person. That is the role our founders put together. We must be men and women of honor and pledge our life, our fortune, and our sacred honor. Our founders did never sacrifice their honor, and because of that, we gained a nation.
Central planners do not understand that when individuals are at their best, society's at its best. We're now run by executive orders, judicial activists, and the worst of all, central planners who policy walk themselves through this and exempt themselves. Those days are over. What you guys have built, the work you have done, and you have a lieutenant governor who has expressed that grassroots, it's even more than grassroots, those roots are so deep they're going nowhere other than up. We are going to change this country from our state. I thank you.
Now we've reached the part of the program where I have instructions to hand the mic to Jackie Van Essendale. But before I do, I've got to say that this event would not have occurred without Jackie Van Essendale and her hard work and the hard work of her committee. She did a fantastic job.
Well, it's time to bring our evening to a close, and I want to say thank you to the Lieutenant Governor for accepting our invitation to be our keynote speaker, and it was wonderful. And we thank him for sharing his evening with us and bringing his family. It was a delight. And we wish him God's blessings and all the wisdom and strength as he governs our state. I also want to thank all of you for taking the time and effort to join us in the celebration, because it wouldn't be much of a party without all of you. So thank you all for coming tonight. And I'd like to thank my committee, and their names are listed in the program, and without them, this would not be possible. And I want to thank Charles. Charles, can you stand up here with me a minute? I'm going to get you back. The Beaufort County Republican Party presents to Charles Hickman a token of appreciation in recognition of many years of outstanding leadership in numerous capacities, and party chairman from April 2012 to March 2013. Reagan Day Dinner, March 15, 2013. Thank you, Charles, for rising to the occasion when we had need. We appreciate it. Tonight here in Beaufort County, we have a message for our nation, our speakers. The sketch in the program refers to this message. Tonight, Beaufort County has a message for America. And we're asking America to remember its Judeo-Christian foundations, embrace them, and return to them. And that's our message tonight. Amen. And I want to thank everyone who expressed that. Our evening is over. I'm going to ask you to stand. Is Kip still here? He left. Oh, that's right. Jonathan's going to do this. Jonathan, would you come forward and lead us in singing God Bless America? Shall we stand? We'll sing this together, and then we'll be dismissed.